He is from an entrepreneurial family indeed. Ratan Baga is the CEO of New World Natural Foods, and he joins us here on The Young Entrepreneurs. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you for having me, Mike.
Nice to see you.
We'll talk about it in a minute, but New World Foods is what we're going to refer to it as. But tell us the story of New World Foods, because it's very much, as I hinted at, a story about a family.
It is a story about it's a story about my family. So it began in 1978 when my eldest uncle came into Canada, and he got into the organic food business. And at that point, he started a whole bunch of retail stores.
Started with, what was it, one shop?
It started very small. So it started with one shop. Only on Commercial Drive, and it was a store, a retail store, and a restaurant. So a lot of stuff was made, because at that point you couldn't buy a lot of organic foods. There were not a lot of brands that were making organic foods.
So I'm old enough to remember.
Yeah. So all those things were made in the back of the kitchen that we used to sell up in the front.
I think every family probably approaches this a little differently. Was there an expectation that this would be something that you and maybe the cousins and the nieces and nephews would go into?
No, it was never an expectation. So when I was growing up, my father never wanted me to go into the family business. He was very blunt about it, actually. He said,
"You're not
make sure
here.
You get your education, because the doors of the business are closed for you." But one thing that he always used to say, and he still says, is that whatever you do in your life, have an entrepreneurial mindset.
Yeah.
So think of everything as a business.
When you think of competitive industries, the industry that you're in, the food industry, the grocery industry, has to be one of the most competitive and fiercely competitive, and going up against a lot of really, really big brands, you know, multinational brands. How do you do that?
So that was, when my father moved here in 98, we started as a distribution company. So we were competing with the big companies out of the United States, who were billion-dollar companies, publicly listed, and we were a small distributor at that point. So that at that point, what we did to sort of pivot ourselves and sort of be more competitive in the market, we started manufacturing our own products, which were all organic, locally made with our own hands. So then we started facing a new type of competitor, which were these big brands.
Right.
So then when our peanut butter was on the shelf, then we were competing with another company who had much more marketing dollars than us, been around in the market much, much longer. But how we sort of created a niche for ourselves was by being organic, by being 100% natural, and being true to our core values.
Ratan, I was talking to someone just the other night, and it was in the context of Launch Academy and the business that she had started, and how specific and special this was to Vancouver, and how we've really seen this grown. Have you found that as well? I mean, I didn't realize that this whole philosophy, or part of this philosophy, was very specific to this city and that support that people are finding.
You mean in terms of entrepreneurship?
Entrepreneurship and that sort of idea of lifting everyone up and giving back. And
I think giving back or being part of the society in a responsible way is very much a West Coast thing or a Vancouver thing.
Yeah.
And a lot of times what happens is you're so busy in doing your things on sort of making your daily day needs meet that you forget about sort of what role am I playing in the society? And you say, okay, you know what, when I turn that chapter of my life, when I turn 35, 40, 50, then I'll start giving back. But you should do that right when you're sort of building your career in a working way, and then you should start doing that at the same time.